We're finna witness the murderous monologue of a menace, cover from out of a sinister, formidable place. I'ma let you know the ins and the outs, and I can spit it wicked, twisted, and you can see by the look in my face. Give me the mic and I'ma mangle it, tangle it. Definitely the people see that I got the hang of it. I think, I could be wrong, you probably gotta ask Logic, but I think that Joyner did so much that Logic is like, I'm not about to try to
compete
with that.
Yeah,
you don't really get why I'm so pissed understanding this. Yeah, I'm an artist and I'm sensitive about my shit. I'm fragile.
My brother.
Oh, yes, man. Yes, how you doing, my bro?
I'm good, man. I'm just working. Right. Working. You hear my stomach? I just ate, so it's digesting. Sorry. I'm still hungry.
That's that hunger.
I'm still hungry. This late in the game, I'm still hungry. And I just ate, and I'm still hungry.
How, man? Let's talk about that for a minute. How are you still hungry? Because listen, dog. When I listen to your music, I understand. You know, I may understand a little more than the average person because I actually rap. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
So I know how complicated it is to switch flow patterns. In a 16 bar, you'll have like seven different flow patterns
and vocals
stacked on top of each other and harmonies and syllable rhymes. And it's just so much that you're doing. And you've been doing it over these years and keeping the same potency.
Yes, ma'am.
How?
I attribute it to me not reaching everybody I feel I need to reach. I feel like I need to reach so many other people. People in Africa, I've never done a show in Africa. People in Japan, I've never done a show in Japan. People in Brazil, I haven't been to Brazil. They're trying to get me to come there in September though, so we're getting somewhere. But it's like there's so many places and so many people I have to infect with this music. I don't feel like that I could let up or become complacent, like, I'm on the Forbes list four times in a row. We got this empire. But I still feel the need to show out lyrically, lyrical acrobatics for my fans and for the people who are just tuning in. You know what I mean? And I have to go at it like I haven't eaten. You know what I'm saying? That's crazy. I ate so much over the years. But my stomach is still growling. You know what I mean? Because it's so many things I want people to see what I have to offer. You know what I'm saying? And what I have to offer is killer lyrics for sure. But my personal experiences I offer, I'm an open book. A lot of MCs won't open their personal book.
Exactly.
Because a lot of MCs use the defense mechanisms like I'm tough, stay away from me, or I'm a, you know, whatever. I've always been inside out. And I think that's how people get to know each other. Open up, be transparent. It's totally transparent in music. I think that a lot of my music is therapeutic for fans. I think a lot more people need to hear that, and I can't stop until I reach everybody. Stamina, I'll be never forever be. Take away by the demons I'll never be. While the weather went up, I'll still rhythm, I come with the heater. Cleverly, take another one, never be. So killer, flowzilla. I recorded Stamina in 95, I think. 95, man. And it's still at the front of my shows. You know what I mean? But I still have hits like Fragile with Kendrick Lamar, like Speed'em with Eminem, like Interlude on the Carter Four with Andre 3000. You know what I'm saying? Right. Just still me and Token, brand new, you know, YouTube rapper.
Right.
Still in the midst of MCs because I feel like I have so much more people to reach. And the hunger.
And the hunger, man. First of all, I need people to really understand how difficult it is, the level of your style. You know what I'm saying?
Yes,
because
is.
A lot of people, they hear, you know, oh, well, that's just how he raps. No.
It's mathematics.
It's mathematics. Scientific.
Yes.
And it's very difficult to keep that level of skill up over, you know, this many years. It's rare.
Playing Russian roulette, I want
people to know that.
Playing Russian roulette with a pen, like you write a bar and you don't know if you can rhyme it. So you're like, okay, I'm gonna see if I can and how many times I can.
You don't know if you can.
Sometimes you'll have the punchline first and have to work backwards.
Yes.
It's all intricate.
Right.
hard as hell to write, especially when it's double and triple time and quadruple time.
And you're doing it throughout the entire album. You know what I'm saying? So I just want to make sure that people understand that, because me personally, when people ask me, hey man, I'm gonna buy a feature and you know I wanna get you on this record, and they send me something that's double time, I gotta charge double because it's double hard. You know what I'm saying? So you do it with ease, you do it effortless, you make it look so simple.
It's hard for me though.
Do you think that good is the enemy of great? Do you think that when people start feeling like they're good, so they get comfortable and relaxed, and then they don't go to the next level to become great?
That's what I think. I think people become complacent when they get to a certain level, man. Like, oh, okay, whatever I do is going to pop. And I've seen artists that pop, and then their next record, the production value goes down and down and down and down. And I see them, I'm like, I never want to be like that. I want my production to always be tip top.
And going up.
Cinematic, baby.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Cinematic.
It is, bro. The Empire, man.
Yeah.
Last time I visited, you guys had two compounds. I heard that you guys made some additions.
There's six of them now.
Six compounds.
Six buildings. No, I think it's six. It's six buildings.
Six buildings.
Yes.
Strange Music, six buildings.
Yes.
Why you need six buildings though?
You need it for everything. We got one for our headquarters.
Okay.
We got one for our studios, Strangeland Studios. Mm-hmm. We got one
Strangeland Studios
for our screen printing, Strange World. Mm. You know what I'm saying? We have one for our construction, Strange Works. We have one lot that we're gonna build a new HQ on. Mm. You know what I'm sizzling? Mm-hmm. And turn the current HQ into a distillery, because we're selling beer and we're selling cocktails and things like that in the future. Mm. You know what I mean? And the sixth one is a car wash.
A car wash?
Yeah.
Where'd that come from?
Yeah. Like, this is clean. Wash, baby. Trap crazy motherfucker. He said, let's do a car wash. I said, okay, let's go. So
I think I missed
the
one.
The original compound? The first one?
No, it's a new building that we just bought right next to Strange Works. So I think it's seven altogether now.
And people need to understand that this was built from the ground up.
Yes. It started in Travis's basement in his old house in Blue Springs, Missouri, and we outgrew that.
Right.
You know what I mean? And then right around the corner from that house, we had to get a little office space that had warehouse space. You know what I'm saying? We outgrew that, which now has us at our current HQ. We outgrew that and had to remodel it to fit more. You know what I'm saying? And we just keep growing.
Keep growing.
We keep growing, and that's a blessing, man, because this is the 20-year anniversary for Strange.
Oh, man, 20 years of Strange Music. You know what I'm saying? That's a testament to anybody that's out here with a vision of trying to get your business off the ground. Mm-hmm. I don't care what, if it's music or not. This man has been in business for 20 years successfully and still growing. Seven buildings.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That's crazy. How do you think Strange Music, you know, is different than like a TDE, like the structure of it? Like, is what, how, because we look at TDE and we look at all these different labels, but how is Strange a little, in your opinion, different than that?
We inspired TDE. And then TDE went with the knowledge that they learned from Strange and went with Iveen. Mm-hmm. Strange is me and Travis. Mm-hmm. It's not an Iveen with us.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Right.
It's not Dr. Dre with us.
Right.
It might be. Seven is pretty good. You know what I'm saying?
Shout out Seven, man.
Seven's pretty goddamn good. Seven. You know what I'm saying? But, you know, he ain't Dr. Dre, but he's got the talent to be.
Right, exactly.
If people really actually knew, you know what I'm saying? And they're starting to know, you know what I'm saying? But that's the difference. Yeah. You know, we're completely independent.
Mm. And that's crazy that you guys... And I think that everybody would agree with that. You know what I'm saying? That they've been inspired some way or another. And, you know, me just touring with you and seeing the inner works, like the big diesel full of merchandise pull up. You know what I'm saying? Like, you was the first one that I seen with a diesel. You know what I'm saying? full of merchandise. First rapper, you know what I'm saying, that I ever saw do that. You know
we did have that on tour, didn't we?
Yeah.
Like, we got a bigger one now.
Oh, man.
We got a bigger one now. Back then it was a little short diesel, you know, so we got a bigger one now. You know what I'm saying?
That's just...
We got a couple of bigger ones now.
That's it. Saturday morning, I ain't got to work. Last night's show sold a lot of merch. Bad
bitch in my bed, so I ain't got a jerk. Forbes list, copy stores, hard to make a dollar. When I was a kid... My family was Christian. We didn't have no comic books. We couldn't have rap or nothing. We had to go to the next door for rap. So when people come in and say, oh, you took the Iron Fist, I'm like, no.
Oh, the brand new. Yeah. What's up with that, man?
Oh, my God. It just kills me.
Oh, wow.
Because the Iron Fist wasn't cracking until a few years, you know what I'm saying?
They're talking
about we were back in the 70s. You might have been, but nobody cared.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
That logo is synonymous with Strange Music.
Yeah, you know straight out the snake and the bat. I don't know what the Iron Fist is, backwards or something. I don't know, but it's similar.
I don't see the Iron Fist one, you know what I'm saying, on the back of people's windshields when I'm driving.
Exactly.
Town, like I see the snake in the bat. You know
exactly.
What I'm saying?
I don't see the Iron Fist tattoo
you know
on
what
people.
I'm saying on people so.
They might have some,
yeah.
But I bet you they don't have more than Strange Music.
I've been to Comic Con. I ain't seen that shit.
Exactly. I've been to Comic Con and I ain't seen it. But I seen Strange Music at Comic Con.
Hell yeah. I mean, I see Strange everywhere, dog.
Yeah, but
I mean,
the fact that it's everywhere, man, you know what I'm saying? That's a testament in itself, you know what I mean? Because it was just
how does that feel, bro, to see that?
It's beautiful. I didn't know back then what I know now as a, what I want to call it, as a man that's evolved.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? I didn't know back then that I was the god of my own universe,
mm-hmm.
that we can put things in place mm-hmm. and manifest these things to life.
Y'all
you know what
that?
I'm saying? And this is a testament to that because it came out of his head, told it to Travis. Travis got some artists to come try to draw it until it was perfectly sleek. Mm. You know what I'm saying? Like really neat, nice, and perfect for a logo. And we knocked it out of the park, man. And now when I think about it, the god of your own universe, you can create things. And it come to life.
You can.
With the right people in place, you can do it. You know what I mean? And that's what it feels like, wow, this reached so many people. The medicine to navigate through the darkness, man. That's what this means. Uh-huh. The snake is from Greek mythology, the rod of Asclepius. You usually see it at a hospital.
Okay.
The snake going around the rod, you know
exactly.
what I'm saying? It's symbolizing medicine.
Right.
The bat wings, supposed to be the nocturnal.
Mm.
Bat is nocturnal.
Yeah.
The medicine to navigate through the darkness. That's what I've been, and that's why people hold it so close, because so many people have darkness in this world.
Mm-hmm.
This is why I created my own planet, my album before Nina, you know what I'm saying? It was called Planet because this one was so corrupt and it's been so corrupt.
Mm.
Not full of love, not full of togetherness, not full of understanding of each other and different cultures and religious beliefs and political beliefs. So I made my own planet where it's all love and togetherness. And Planet Pune, bro. Yeah. And now this is everywhere, man. Mm. You know what I'm saying? That's a beautiful thing, but I'm trying to get it so many more places.
And you have to, man.
Yes.
You know, because if that's the mission, you're going to achieve it. Like you said, you create in your own universe.
Mm-hmm.
And I'm really big on the universal laws, you know what I mean? So
yes.
When it comes to the law of vibration, the law of attraction.
Yes.
You know, those things are real.
Yes, sir.
You just mentioned back then when you first started, you know what I'm saying? And you had these visions of what you were going to do to the game, how your position, what everything, you know. You had your hair dyed red, way before everybody was.
And everybody called all my dudes in the hood called me gay. They called me all kind of things. Man, you look like Eve, you know, because Eve was popping back then.
Right,
I guess.
Right.
You know,
hit you with the Eve, huh?
You know what I'm saying? Devil worshiper,
all
everything.
That
not that I'm from a blood neighborhood, but I'm a devil worshiper.
Right,
you know what I'm saying?
Right.
It couldn't be that I'm just King Blood with a red crown.
Little
it couldn't
crown.
Be that.
That
couldn't be that. It got to be the devil worshiper. When devil worshiping is not popular in the hood.
with
not at all.
You know, with black folks.
Exactly.
You're not gonna get that off.
Man, that's gonna be
if there's a devil one. Worshiper on the block, yeah. He's gonna get the business.
Quickly.
Quickly.
Because we don't play with that type
are of religious. Exactly. Where do they do that at?
Yeah, where?
So
nigga, where?
Red hair back then. Nobody. That's why I wrote The Lord of Weird. My little one said, so we're sitting at Bossa Nova, like on my last tour up here. I forgot where Bossa Nova is.
Yeah, Bossa Nova.
Yeah. And we were having dinner there. It was me and my youngest Rainbow. And she's like, Dad, it's just so crazy that now after all these years, like Lil Yachty and Trippy Red and all these people are, all these new kids are dyeing their hair red and it's cool now. Lil Uzi Vert and all these people. And you did it so long ago, like 20 years ago, and people shun you for it.
Yeah.
And now it's cool to be weird. And you're like the Lord of Weird. And I'm like, ooh, the Lord of Weird.
Said,
I love it, Rainbow. Thank you. So that's the first song on Nina.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? That was the first time I needed it. I did it so long ago.
That's dope.
But now it's a thing.
Yeah, I mean, that's just being so far ahead of your time, it don't even make sense. Mm-hmm. And dealing with the backlash, you know, when you even type in the word artist on an iPhone, the first emoji pops up is somebody who's colorful and all that, you know, that's just what it is, man. Yeah. We artists, we create, we live in different worlds, we create it's planets, like you said.
It's unfortunate that when you're good, extremely good at what you do, like yourself,
thank you.
It's unfortunate that people like us, of course we got fans and we have a core that are always tuned in, but even when you're in the game long enough and elite long enough, people get used to you and be like, oh, I expect that from him. It ain't nothing no more. I expect that from him. You know what I'm saying? I expect that from Eminem. Oh, it ain't nothing.
Yeah.
But it used to be like, whoa.
Yeah.
Whoa. It's unfortunate that we get like, yeah, well, it's cool now. You know what I'm saying? But it was better back in 2001. I'm like, nah, I wouldn't even polish like I am now.
At all.
And
they don't
I fight them about it. I'm like, put it up against each other. What you talking about?
What is you talking about?
What are you talking about? Now, people are nostalgic. Mm. These records are personal to them.
Right.
They was going through certain things with those records. I get it. But now these new kids are going through things with your new records.
Right.
And those people are like, nah, these kids don't know what the hell until they come back. Yeah, they go back.
Right.
But it's unfortunate that like people get typecast, you know what I'm saying? Like, oh, I already know it's gonna be dope. I don't even wanna hear what Crooked gonna say because he gonna kill everything.
Yeah, that's.
I wanna hear Crooked kill everything.
Man, why y'all be doing that?
You know what I'm saying? That's crazy.
Yeah,
They've been doing it to me for years.
Yeah,
I see them doing it to him.
You paint Picassos every time.
Yeah.
And they like, okay, we see now. Where's the Rembrandt?
Yeah.
And it's like, yo.
Yeah.
You know, but what I hate is when they like, yo, you got to hear this new kid. He killed it. Then I go listen to it and it's diarrhea. You know what
I'm
saying?
Oh my God.
I hate that.
It happens so much.
I hate that. But speaking like new kids, this Lil Nas X kid, man, he got the country song. You familiar with it?
Yeah, Old Town Road.
Old Town Road.
And they took it off the country charts because they said it's not country, but it is to me.
Mm-hmm.
It's just he's not a country artist, I guess.
Yeah.
He's a rapper.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
So what do you think about that? Because you was kind of pioneering that lane too, as far as just being in different genres, bending genres
I feel like
together.
That people put labels on and they shouldn't.
Right.
I think if this feels like a country song and country folk are playing it and country folk are doing remixes to it,
right,
it should be just it's good country music.
Right.
It shouldn't be what category you think he's in or he put himself in. I'm a rapper, but I did me a country song. I'm a rapper, but I did a gospel song.
Yeah.
I'm a rapper, but I did a blues song.
Absolutely.
I'm a rapper, but I did a metal song.
Right.
You know
what
I'm sizzling?
Right.
So
you
because
did.
I'm a rapper, I can't be on the country charts, but that song sounds so country.
And it resonated with people who like country music.
Yes. People create barriers and he got barriered.
Wow.
But it didn't stop his rise.
Uh-uh. It didn't stop him. He still did his thing. Right now, there's a huge Tech N9ne fan.
Okay.
You know, he's scared to start rapping. He wants to rap.
Mm-hmm.
He's scared, but he's a huge Tech N9ne fan. He goes to all the shows. He buys all the merch. He gets the VIP meet and greet ticket. Yep. He's so fucking starstruck when he's trying to get you to sign his fucking CD. His hand is shaking and shit. You know what I'm saying?
That happens every day.
And then he fucking forgets to ask you the question that he told himself he would ask you.
That happens all the time.
How does he get over the fear of failure and go chase his dreams like you
did? It's the hardest thing to do. To get over fear in life, it's the hardest thing because fear starts with your eyes first. You have to see it to feel like, oh, I'm scared of that. I fear not too many things on this planet, but I don't fear animals. I don't fear people, but I fear lightning. Mm. You know what I mean? Like, oh, every time it happens, like, oh. And I don't feel like I did anything wrong that I'd get struck down with lightning. There's two things I fear, lightning and parallel parking, because I can't do it. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
That's it. But I got this thing I've been doing on this tour. It's called Enter Fear. Like, that's going to be my next title for my record, my next record. I'm already planning my next record. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
It's called Enter Fear, E-N-T-E-R. F-E-A-R together. Right. You know what I'm saying? One word, enter fear. I'm entering fear and I want to exit the motherfuckers.
Right.
So when I enter fear on this show, I come out to one of my new intricate songs called Nina. And you have to hit it right. I've been a killer in a game when I first put the pants at the padlock the first day out. Now I'll be a thriller with the thing when I first take a man with the gab in the verse they shout. Like one of the people at the church play crouch. When you put a graphic on the picture out in the workday couch and the birthday spouse at the house, my brother do on a birthday blouse. That's hard to do right here.
They can't do it.
Right here.
I'm talking to rappers out there.
So I'm entering fear. And if you see me, if you come to the show now and you see my mic moving like that, that's anxiety.
Yeah.
Because sometimes I have to stop it.
Mm.
You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to enter fear. So I put that there. So I can get over that fear. And I'm getting better with it.
Mm.
I've been 2 weeks on the tour. I'm getting better with it. I put Fragile back on the show because I've been running from it for a gang of shows.
Mm.
The big hit that I did with Kendrick Lamar and Mayday and Kendall Morgan, I've been running from. It's gold. It's probably on its way to platinum right now.
Right.
And I was running from it. That's stupid.
Mm.
I have to interfere and do some of the people appointed to give him the penny again. Never do get it. I want you to come on Gabala Jimmy and die. Need to be given the remedy again. Why? Critics are really the enemy and I can't stand the way they slam today's gifted. Effing incredible, get fanned away with grants to pay. This gem will a script to Devin impeccable. Right around, I'm gonna put everything in a flow. I'm the non, I'm gonna look very mean when I fall. Scribe a line, but he has never been at a show. By the time, it'd be better living in the still. You gotta rhyme all that shit. I'm entering fear, my nigga. And I put it back on the show. I didn't do it yesterday because I'm still punking out every once in a while. You know what I'm saying? I'm like, and there's one more on the show. It's called Midwest Choppers 1. I haven't done it since 09, dude. And I put it back on the show because I'm trying to enter all my fears as a man. Mm. And I won't be able to do that record that's coming after Nina, Interfere, if I'm still a fearful bitch ass motherfucker that's scared to fucking get in there and, you know, a parallel park and get it right.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? Or duck when the lightning strikes, or do these songs I've been running from.
Yeah.
Man, Midwest Choppers 1 is horrible. You're finna witness the murderous monologue of a menace, kept of him out of a sinister, formidable place. I'ma let you know the ins and the outs, and I can spit it wicked, twisted, and you can see by the look in my face. Give me the mic and I'ma mangle it, tangle it. Definitely the people see that I got the hang of it. Oh, it's fucked up. Gotta give it up, I'm a veteran. Like Edison, I'ma light him up and get in your head again. I'm better than never, never let a veteran death to be fetish. Seven hit the mic and then we peddle in medicine. I'ma chop, chop, chop. You know, that's fucked up.
And you know, that shit is hard to do on stage live with the breath control.
Like, why did I do it to myself? Because I'm trying to interfere, so. When the fan is shaking and everything, the hardest thing to do is get over your fear. But Will Smith said, some of your wildest dreams are on the other side of fear, my nigga. It's so real.
Absolutely.
It's so real. I don't know.
But man, that shit just gave me the chills right there. You know what I'm saying? That's some real ass shit.
Yeah,
you
know fear is fear.
Because I got songs I run from on stage. I'm like, there ain't no way I'm going to get that song all the way out. You know what I mean? Because I wrote it in such a complex manner that to deliver it live on stage, it has to, every pocket has to be on time.
I don't know how you did what you did on that wake up show live freestyle, man. And you said,
word.
Unplugged. That's how you rap. That's how you freestyle on Unplugged. Right. That whole thing, man. Thank I still you, show bro. That to people, dog. You remember I posted it?
Yeah, yeah, you did. You did. Nah, I said, you're good at giving people
this
props,
is how
man.
It's supposed to be done.
You very good at giving people props, man. And you and sharing your platform with people like, yo, look, this is dope. Like, you don't have to do none of that shit. And a lot of artists refuse.
Yes.
If they're not part of your team, your squad, they're not gonna give you no props. They're not gonna say your name.
I know.
And
I sent my new little clip for Like I Ain't to a lot of stars.
Right.
And not too many of them posted.
Exactly. That's how the game goes.
You know, you're going to DM and say, this is my new,
this for me.
Everybody I mentioned, you know what I'm saying? Yeah. The Rock posted it immediately. Bow.
Now, what's up with that, bro? Because I peeped that. He was like, yeah, I work out. He said he works out to your music. Yeah. You make his favorite like workout playlist and shit. That shit crazy, bro.
Yeah, man. I just met him for the first time last year on a set of Ballers here in L.A., man. Mm. You know, and he said, I don't know what we're going to do. I'm a big fan, but we're going to do something.
Right.
And we've been in cahoots, you know what I'm saying, like on social media, you know what I'm saying?
And that's better than these rappers posting that shit.
Man.
Since they don't want to post it.
He posted it.
You know what I'm saying? Y'all scared of competition out there.
Yeah, some people just didn't respond. Yeah. But I get it.
Didn't even posting that. Why would we show our fans that you're better than me? You know what I'm saying?
I don't know what that's.
You know what I'm saying? That's how they feel. You know, hey, well, I'm going to say it for you. You know what I'm saying? They ain't trying to show their fans. You know what I'm saying? Some real ass rapping. You feel me?
You know what I'm saying? I'm trying to reach so many more people. So a campaign like that, like the major folks up there, hey man, post this on Instagram, man. Right. This is like my new video. It's just the first verse. And it's beautiful, beautifully put together. And some people just didn't respond.
It's a community, dog. Like, we just gotta support each other more, in my opinion. You know what I'm saying? Because
I posted Snow the Product stuff on my she's not one of my artists. No. She's just a friend.
You posted my little brother's the horse you got.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying? I mean, I'm already knowing, bro. I do the same thing. I share my platform. That's why we go live on Crook's Corner sometimes, live from my backyard. Shout out to my gardener. He finally cut that wild shit down the back. Mm-hmm. Y'all ain't gotta see that shit. But I let people come in and they spit bars on my live. Yes. You know what I'm saying? Yes. And we just try to share our platform and create a community.
That's what you're supposed to do, man. That's what you're supposed to do. I'm looking for shooters, man. I'm always looking for shooters. That's why I found Horseshoe Gang.
Yeah.
I'm looking for shooters lyrically. Yeah. I want the code. All of us are on the same team.
Yeah, we are.
All of us are on the same team,
we
man.
Are. Absolutely.
You know what I'm saying? You know the ones who act funny.
Yeah.
They ain't on the same team.
Yeah.
They might be shooters too, but they ain't in our circle.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, we got the Jedi Council.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Speaking of shooters, Logic Joyner Lucas.
Uh-huh.
You know, Joyner's a shooter.
Yes.
In my opinion.
Yes, he is.
He recently said that Logic gave you a half-ass verse on Sriracha.
Yeah.
What do you think about that? Is that?
Well, the way it came about is that I showed the track to Logic on his tour.
Right.
I went on his tour bus and I played it for him. He's like, oh yeah, I'm on that one. I said, okay. But he got so busy.
Yeah.
It took him like 6 months or more. You know what I'm saying? Within that 6 months, I met Joyner. Mm-hmm. And he got on my tour bus, and I said, this is the one I'm going to do with Logic. Mm-hmm. And he said, oh, let me get on there with Logic. I'm like,
He want all the smoke, huh?
I said, okay. I said, he ain't did it yet. So I'm a G.
Mm-hmm.
I gave Joyner the song. I said, okay, you do a verse.
Mm-hmm.
When he sent it back to me, I sent it to Logic.
Right.
I'm like, hey, man, I've been waiting on you to do this. This is Joyner.
Yeah.
He said he wanted to do it with us. Man, I know it's just supposed to be me and you.
Right.
But this is a new guy too, man, and this will be exciting.
Right.
And all Logic said, son can rap. You know what I'm saying? But I think, I could be wrong. You probably got to ask Logic. But I think that Joyner did so much that Logic is like, I'm not about to try to
compete
with that.
Yeah, I'm about to even.
You know what I'm saying?
No.
You know, he say.
Which happens.
And he freestyled. I didn't know that his fans are used to him freestyling.
Mm,
but when Tech N9ne give you a song, you come with it.
You bring your A-game.
You know what I'm saying?
Bring your A-game.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? A-game.
You know, and I still put it out because I peeped his fans would have appreciated it. But I told Joyner, that, man, I just wish he didn't freestyle, man. I wish he would have just went and did him, did his chopper style.
Did what he do, when he do his chopper style.
Because Joyner actually did blah, 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 at the end.
He left his body.
And I'm like, oh.
He left his body.
If he would have sent that to me, I would have still did me. Yeah. But I was like, well, he went as fast as we could go, so yeah. I'm not going to do that. You know what I'm saying? But I'm going to do this.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Go ahead. Do you. You know?
But he sent me a freestyle. Wow. And when I looked at the comments, his fans were like, wow, Logic killed it. I'm like, okay.
Hey, there you go.
Okay.
Yeah.
So I made the right move.
Yeah, exactly.
But
exactly.
When I told Joyner that, Joyner went live and like Tech N9ne is pissed off about it. He sent him a bunk verse, you know, like, saying? Because I try to keep everything cool.
Right.
And on the under, and then stuff we could talk about amongst each other without talking out.
To everybody.
You know what I'm saying? But he said it, because Joyner is real like that.
Right.
You know what I mean? But the way I brought it to Joyner was like, man, I just wish he didn't freestyle, man.
Yeah, that's
damn.
It. Yeah, that's it.
I wanted him to go.
Yeah, I'm a fan of him when he goes.
So when Logic called me after all of it transpired, he said, Tech, are we good, man? I said, yeah. It's just MC shit, dog.
Yeah, MC shit.
You know,
shit.
That's absolutely all it is. So what's up? Hold up. Tech, I'm sorry for the hold up, but I've been on the road. Should have had this verse
to your ass a long time ago. When I put that on everything, I ain't had a minute. Speaking of MC shit, man, the people was, you know, because I kind of quietly ask people, hey man, what you want me to ask Tech N9ne? You know what I'm saying? You know what I mean?
Yes.
People wanted to know, you know, if in your opinion, what three rappers you think could go bar for bar with you and keep up with your cadence on a record? You know what I'm saying? Keep up with your patterns. I got my opinion of the three, but who you think?
You've done it. You've done it and killed on that Forever MC thing.
Thanks, bro.
Like a reptilian, a regenerate. Oh! California, I'm the king of the state. Oh!
That was a fun record.
Why you do us like that?
That was a fun
Why'd
record.
You do us like that?
That was a fun record.
Oh, my God. I am not overreacting either. Anybody who heard the record, y'all know. Wherever the cameras are, y'all know. Don't front.
Mm-hmm.
Don't front. Oh, that verse, man.
I appreciate it, bro. Nah, you know, it's like you said, he told me, yo, you know, we getting Tech N9ne on this joint. I said, okay. I gotta go.
Stand tall as a monolith. What?
Yeah, I'm like, what? Yeah. Anytime, like if you send a record or if Eminem send a record, it's just a whole nother vibe, you know, that you gotta put yourself into. You know what I mean? You're gonna play yourself very badly if you just, you know, I'm gonna go in here and just rap. No, this is, like I said, Jedi Council, I mean that shit.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
Like, and it's only a few people in the whole game that make me feel like I gotta go into my super bag.
Yes,
you know what I mean?
Yes.
You one of them.
Yeah.
M's one of them. Royce is one of them.
Royce is one of them.
You know what I'm saying? These people make me feel like I gotta go.
So let me tell you a story. Let me tell you a story about Fragile.
Mm.
Okay, I got the beat from Mayday. Kendall Morgan's already on the singing. Boom, they're singing together. I get the record. Some dude saw me perform at Pay Dues, worked for the LA Times, and said Tech N9ne was lip syncing. I was so good that I was beside myself.
He said, what?
Oh, he wrote it. Some of the people appointed to giving the penny and never do get it. I want you to come on Gobble of Jimmy and die.
Yeah.
Need to be given the remedy and why? Critics are really the enemy and I.
Yeah.
Can't stand the way they slam today's gifted. Effing incredible, get fanned away with grants to pay. This gem will lay scripted, deaf and impeccable. You know, I'm talking about him.
Mm.
You don't really get why I'm so pissed understanding this. Yeah. I'm an artist and I'm sensitive about my shit. I'm fragile.
Yeah.
So I did that verse.
Yeah.
Yellow Wolf came on my bus. He's like, man, I'm not inspired. Tech, nothing is inspiring me. He's telling me stories about his last album and thing, and he's not really happy.
Right.
I played him. I said, hey, I'm about to send Kendrick this song, because after I did my verse, I said, I need somebody that can go after that.
Because, you already
and know. It's not too many of us.
Yeah.
You know this.
Mm-hmm.
It's not too many of us. So I'm like, Kendrick better talk about this. I hope he can talk about critics. Mm-hmm. I'm sure he can.
Right.
So Kendrick hadn't done the song yet. And I played it for Yellow Wolf on my tour bus. And he's like, oh my God, that inspires me so much, Tech. Please let me do this. Kendrick will not be able to do this. Right. I'm like, why not? He said, he can't do that.
Right.
I was like, I think he can.
Right.
And I said, but if it's I said, maybe we can all be on the song, bro. Mm-hmm. Okay, go ahead. I gave it to Yellow Wolf. He never did it.
Yo, Catfish, what's happening, man?
I gave it to
I'll
him.
Let you real quick.
I gave him Fragile, and it's a hit.
And it's a hit.
Yeah, I gave it to him.
He had it. Had to shoot Yellow Wolf after this.
He had it. Because Kendrick was on tour.
Yeah.
Kendrick actually did it in Cleveland on his tour.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? And it was tight how he did it. You know what I'm saying? But before that, before Kendrick got to it, because he had already committed to it, but he hadn't done it yet because he was on tour.
Yeah.
Yellow Wolf was in there like, let me get that, man. He can't do it. I'm like, he can do it, man.
Yeah, he felt that. He felt that inspiration right then and
there.
Yeah,
yeah. And I was glad that something made him feel like that.
And then later
but he never did it.
He never did it.
He could have been on that song.
I got some never did it too, man.
Yeah.
So, you know.
That song is short enough for another verse. You know what I mean?
Wow.
Yeah.
That's funny, man.
Yeah, he never did
you
it.
You never know what you miss out on. Just put the work
nah,
in.
Nah, man, he's good now, man. He found his niche. And
he's good,
I see him popping up everywhere, man. He's doing his Thug Thizzle, man.
Guess what, though? When you miss out, though, you still feel that little ouch. You know what I'm saying? Like, damn.
Yeah.
But
Could you hear Yellow Wolf with his twang on that song? That would have been tight.
God. Yellow Wolf be finding them slippery pockets to fall in.
Tech N9ne, Yellow Wolf, Kendrick, Fragile. Ooh, but it's still Tech N9ne, Kendrick, Mayday, Kendall Morgan, boom.
You don't really get why I'm so pissed. Understand this. I'm an artist and I'm sensitive about my shit. Yes, I'm
fragile. Man, how does it feel to be independent with all these milestones and all these accomplishments, dog? Like,
it's
a book. Like, we ready to read the book.
You gonna think I'm crazy, but we just do the work and we're like, oh, it went platinum. Oh, let's keep going.
Right.
Oh, that went gold. Oh, okay, well, let's keep going. We do the work and we look back like, oh my God, they surprised me on stage. That's when I know, with plaques. I'm like, oh, whoa, we've been going so much.
Yeah.
That it's just an afterthought.
Storm. You causing the storm.
Yeah, yeah. We're just trying to touch people, man. You know what I'm saying? So I'm just passing it up and I'm just doing all the work. And then it'll come back to me somehow. Just like I came up with a drink in 95 called a Caribou Lou. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And I mixed 151 Malibu rum and pineapple juice together. You know what I'm saying? With me and Scooby and Scooby and T-Will in our old little bar that we had on Prospect. You know what I'm saying? And I'm tasting it. I'm like, ooh, it tastes Caribbean. Caribbean Lou. Caribou Lou. You know what I'm saying? And I did that and it touched so many people that it went gold, then it went platinum, then it touched Boulevard Brewing Company, and now my beer, Bulu Beer, is nationwide now.
Congrats on that.
Yeah,
like,
man.
That's big. Like,
yeah.
So you got the beer, it's in stores right now, and they can go get it like,
yeah,
just right now, just I walk in, I'll get a Bulu.
BevMo, I'm sure it's
BevMo.
There. You know what I'm saying?
That's big, bro.
Yeah, man, it's going to be everywhere. If it ain't there yet, it's going to be there.
Yeah, that's hot. That's crazy. And it all just came from chilling with what's up, school?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? I fuck with school, man.
Yeah, me too.
So y'all was just chilling and you came up with the idea.
Mm-hmm. Because we just had
you said 151?
151 Malibu and pineapple
juice.
We had just had a, the night before, we just had E-40 and the Click there at our club. They performed.
Right.
Sugar T was there. Be Legit was there. Yeah. D-Shot was there. Everybody was there. I don't even, Lavinity might even be there. I don't know. It was a long time ago.
Right.
And they had Slurricane.
Exactly.
And when we was cleaning up the next day, T-Will said, we need to have our own drink with 151. I'm like, okay, let's go. And I start mixing it up. I'm a mixologist. I didn't know that I was a mixologist back then.
Right.
I got so much better.
Mm-hmm.
I'm probably going to have a place one day, a bar. You know what I'm saying? I'm so cold with the mixtures, you know what I mean, and creating drinks, you know. I didn't know that I was creating a monster with Caribou Lou, though, that would bubble into.
You gotta be a mixologist if you gonna mix anything with fucking 151.
Yes. And make it taste
like
it's not in it.
It's not in it.
Yes.
You a master mixer at that point. Because that shit right there, you can put that shit in your gas tank.
Yes. And all my fans, like, what are you gonna do now that 151 Bacardi don't sell it no more? I said, we're making our own. What do you mean? I'm glad they don't sell it. Thank you.
Do it like I wasn't a starter, that wasn't a Carter.
Wheezy?
Wasn't an order, my cousin the water.
Feezy?
Nothing was bought up but busting and touching the heart of people that's loving the hardest stuff.
Yeah, I'm like, so Nina, man, it's like, it's fresh. My youngest Rainbow called me like, Daddy, I'm so proud of you. This album is so now, but you.
Right.
I'm gonna say, that's what I was trying to do,
and
Rainbow.
And it sounds like that, like, from the even, but the intro is so evangelistic.
Yes, it is.
You know what I'm saying? The intro to the album make you feel like, okay, I'm about to go to church.
Yes.
I'm about to go to rap church on the
I'm showing you how large my following is. Mm,
exactly.
It sounds like a legion.
It does. And it is.
You know what I'm saying?
I didn't even know.
Who's the number one independent rapper in the world?
Nina.
Nina.
Yeah.
Somebody say Nina. Nina. Yeah. Nina. Nina.
Yeah, that's it.
You know what I'm saying? Yeah, like, I'm letting you know that I have an army.
An army.
Yeah.
And man, you about to go across the states again.
Yeah.
Yo, bro, how do you do? You like a fucking machine, bro.
Oh yeah, I feel like a machine
that
now.
That tour that you invited Slaughterhouse on, man.
Oh my God.
For those who don't know, Slaughterhouse, when we first assembled, our first nationwide tour, Tech N9ne put us on our first nationwide tour, you know, at Slaughterhouse.
Yeah, and, Royce came to me and said, hey, Tech, man, we rapping our ass off up there, and in the middle of us rapping, the fans start screaming Areola. And I was like, take my song, put it in y'all machine, and when they start doing it, play the hook. Ooh, Areola, ooh, Areola. And they say, can we do our shit now? They didn't do it.
They didn't do it. I told them what to do, you know what I'm saying? See, that was like our first time as, you know, a group. Uh-huh. First of all, we trying to figure each other out.
I know.
And then we get thrown into one of the, that was being in the Gladiator pit.
I know.
A strange music tour for those who don't know. If you're not ready for this, I seen some artists that's like, you know, they had to go home because they couldn't take the work. You know what I'm saying? Back to back to back to back to back shows.
Yeah.
And you know, you up early in the morning for the meet and greet, you up late at night on stage, and it's just a cycle. And it made a man out of me, you know what I mean? As far as on the road. Like,
that's
can't nobody
said.
Tell me shit about going on the road no
if
more.
If you can do that, you can do anything.
You could do any, all that other shit is a walk in the park.
Yes.
You tour with this man will make you a fucking real artist, touring artist. You know what I'm saying?
Yes.
From top to the bottom, they got booklets and they got rules and codes and things that you have to, you know, you get your ass fined if you don't do certain shit. So,
all the tools to keep you on tour and keep you gaining fans is what all the rules are put in place for. You know what I'm saying?
And it works, man.
Mm-hmm.
So, you know, I mean, you know, I'm forever thankful to you for putting us on the road like
Come on, man.
You know what I'm saying?
I fuck with shooters.
Man, we need that out here. So we really got to acknowledge that. You know what I'm saying? Acknowledge how thankful and grateful we are.
Yeah, man. We got to uplift our shooters, man.
We do, man.
This dude's on the radio that don't have a rhythm idea. We really got to get the shooters popping, man. And it's shooters popping, don't get me wrong.
Right. No, it's something. Yeah, it's something out there.
But it's an epidemic.
Oh, yeah.
It's some rhythm happens.
There's some goofy rapping going on, dog. Some of that shit's so goofy.
Yeah. I'm talking about, you know, but when you hear it in the club and you drinking, you know what I'm saying? You don't want to hear nobody doing Midwest Choppers in the club.
Right.
You know what I'm saying?
Unless she popping that thing right on time, you know
now,
what I mean?
Now, like I ain't. Yeah.
Yeah, like I ain't.
That's a perfect, it's a perfect blend of being a shooter and that frequency that's been dominating the airwaves, that tribal frequency that's been dominating the airwaves for the past 5 or 6 years.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? That trap, kind of like, you know, trap nigga shit. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, yeah.
But with lyrics on top of it.
Lyrics on top.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, nah, that's one of my joints right now. That I'm back to back in Eddie's too right now.
Yes.
You know what I'm saying?
Eddie's is dope.
I'm back to back.
Eddie's
that.
Is
but
dope.
But that's how I go through an album. You know, I'm cleaning up my bedroom and I'm just got one on loop.
Yeah.
And then later on, I start with another one. So as far as the album goes, what's the first visual?
Like I Ain't.
Like
well,
I Ain't.
Actually, the first visual was a cartoon. It was an animated one.
Oh, with the animation.
Yes.
Yeah,
animated.
Yeah.
You know
that
what
I'm
saying? The Tristan did. And that one's popping. But I did this 5-part series. I wrote it when I was in Europe. It's called Cathartic with a K. I ain't banging because Cathartic is with a C. I ain't banging at all. cathartic. Reason why I spelled it with a K is because backwards in the movie, cathartic says Citratec. And that's some medicine I created that they try to give us in the detainment center to subdue us. And you can hear the lady in the back going, Citratec is cathartic. It keeps going back and forth. Citratec is cathartic. Right. They want to try to brainwash you. They don't want you to be forthcoming. They don't want you to be boisterous. They don't want you to speak out. They don't want you to rebel. You know what I'm saying? So they use Citratec against us. And this five-part series I wrote called Cathartic, Like I Ain't, is the second episode. The first episode is in the screens on my tour tonight.
Okay.
That's the only way you can see it until the tour is over. Then we put it all together.
And you put it all together.
So when people see Like I Ain't, like episode two, we give you pieces of the episode one. Mm-hmm. Previously on Cathartic, episode one. Like, this is a real
That's
series.
Dope.
Yeah. And they show you what happens in the screen, kind of. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And like, they're like, how we miss it? Y'all didn't. Y'all just didn't come to the show.
You gotta go to the show to see episode one.
Yeah. So after Like I Ain't, that was the first one. And it's popping right now. It's already at 2 million. After that, episode three is coming, which is Disparagement. After Disparagement, episode four is the one I did with Jelly Roll. It's called Easier For You. It's an anti-suicide song. And part five is one, the last one is called I Caught Crazy.
But in case you want to know how sin tastes, I want to try to help another save a brother from a grim fate. How could you make friends break down and act like an ingrate? Selfishness.
Mega talented, working, touring, controlling the merch game. Uh-huh. You know what I'm saying? Like, you're doing so much, man. We just really, really thank you for stopping by.
Man, thank you for having me, brother.
Giving us a piece of your time, especially being on the road. I know how that go, you know what I mean? You want all the little downtime you could get.
Yeah,
you
know I need to go back to sleep, and I don't know if I'm going to be able to. You know what I'm saying? I'm on Crook's Corner, though, man.
You know what I'm saying? That's what it is. So, man, you know, Tech, man, from the heart, bro. Thank you.
Thank you, brother. You know what I'm saying?